was for him recruiting wise. I mean, everybody knows the impact of Jarnell, but just how important is this place as a city for you to recruit and recruit it well?
It's a great city, a lot of talented players, great high school coaches. We have good relationships with great summer coaches, AU coaches. That's the most important thing, the grassroots level, getting to know guys, building relationships. And that's when you have a high level of success in recruiting. You got to build the relationships because you recruit guys all the time, but you don't have relationships, it'll be tough. So you got to get in this area. It's a great city, great place to be.
And I think it was confirmed this week that Trey Golden's not going to be a part of the team moving forward. How do you guys, I guess, what happened in that situation, if you can speak on it, and then how do you guys moving forward kind of accommodate for a point guard, a guy who's going to be a senior, not being there?
Well, anytime you lose a senior, very talented player, a guy that won big games for you, played in a lot of exciting games for you. As a coach at Tennessee, I won 39 games with Trey Golden, so he's a big part of what we did as a program, and moving forward has helped in a lot of ways, and we just wish Trey Golden the best.
And so what do you do moving forward with, I mean, you guys were limited there anyways, trying to move guys around. How do you foresee that position changing?
Well, we feel good about our pieces. We have some good guys, very talented guys. Obviously, Jordan Stokes and Josh Richardson, very talented player. Jordan McRae, an elite player. Amani Moore. Getting Jerron Maimon back, who's playing really well for us. So we're excited about the guys that are coming in as well. Robert Hubbs, a guy from this area who had a great high school career. Darius Thompson, a guy from out of Nashville. A.J. Davis, a high school kid. So a lot of talent on the table. When you lose a guy like this, it's obviously tough, and you got to push forward. But we'll be okay.
How much is it realistic to maybe expect a new guy to come in and help there, you know, Darius or something like that?
Well, I think you always look. That's the most important thing. You always look and you always evaluate. But you're not just bringing anybody in. That's the most important thing because I think we have a great core. You don't want to mess up that core of what we have. The guys are continuing to progress. When you're bringing guys in, you want to be the right fit because the three incoming or the four incoming guys with Big Pops, the junior college kid, our guys have constantly been in contact with those guys on a consistent basis. So if you're bringing somebody in, you want it to be the right fit. If not, you won't do it.
You talked about Jerron coming back. Where is he health-wise, and what have you seen out of him in the last couple of weeks?
I haven't seen him in the last couple of weeks because of the NCAA rules with finals and all that. But before that, he's working out, skill work. His shot has really improved. His body looks good. He'll probably lose about 10 more pounds with continued conditioning. He played in some pickup games, 5-on-5, but not every day. They limit his pickup games, but he did everything from a skill standpoint on the floor. But he looks great. Skill has gotten a lot better, and it was fun to have him out there.
Well, what can he learn from a year like this where he probably wasn't expecting this in October, November? But what have you seen him learn from this experience?
I think the keys with Jerron, he was always a humble guy. He appreciated playing the game. He's one of those guys that did everything his team needed to be successful. He didn't mind doing that. So he's one of those guys that appreciated that part of it. But I think in sitting back and watching and evaluating, really appreciate the game because of what happens when it's taken away from him. So I think he understands that part. He's excited to be back on the floor. He has a lot of energy, and the guys feel good in having him around because it's like having that big brother out there. And he does a really good job of leading guys and helps guys follow his lead.
What is it about the Memphis high school talent specifically that makes you feel like you need to have a presence here in the city?
I mean, you have to, not just because of at the University of Tennessee. You're talking about a city with so many talented players and also surrounding cities. Per capita in the country is one of the best, if not the top five in the country as far as talent on a consistent basis. But the thing about it, they're talented, they have a level of toughness, they play basketball all the time. And I think those are things we take for granted. Sometimes guys just play inside. These guys here play outside, they'll play against older guys. And when you have that type of chemistry and flow with young guys, you got a chance to be very successful when you get these guys in your program.
When you look at Stokes, how do you want to see his game progress as he goes forward?
You know, Jarnell, one of those guys, very prideful in his game. He's made a lot of great strides. And the one thing about Jarnell, he mentioned something about, you know, the NBA scouts wanted to see him shoot the ball. He didn't shoot as much. But that was me more than Jarnell. Jarnell can make shots. He's really shooting it well. He's a guy that can make plays off the bounce. And I mean, it's exciting to watch him play and watch him grow as a player. I think he'll be fun to watch with all the things he's capable of doing. But he spends a lot of time in the gym. He tweeted something last night about, you know, 1 or 2 in the morning. He's always in the gym. Now, I just got to do a better job of getting him into bed. But he's always in the gym.
All right, thanks, guys.
Thank you.